I now expect the various group leaders to paint your results on the wall. Then once we have pinned everything on the wall, I now expect every group, you now go and see what other groups has done in those walls. So you'll be moving as a group, then you see the response on the table and the graph for your colleagues. Group 7, let us paint ours here. Is it possible? Once you have moved and see what others have done, and we discuss if it is similar result to the one you have received.
If you can attend.
The mechanical advantage is one if you round off. So if the load is
the mechanical advantage is a the mechanical advantage is usually a
These are their gradient.
Their gradient is mechanical advantage. As you can see, they are it's a straight line from the origin, and it is constant. That is the mechanical advantage.
I believe we are now come up with the result from the various group. It is now the reporting stage. I now expect the secretaries for various groups. We have group 1, where is group 1? Group 2? Secretary group 2? Group 3? Secretary group 3, group 4, secretary group 4, group 5. So now you will be coming, then you give us the report which you have, the results you have there. Therefore, we expect to have the table and we also expect to have a sketch of the graph. All of us have moved around and you have seen what our other group has done. That's right?
Yes.
So let us have group 1 and group 7 coming to report. Just write the result, group 1 and group 7.
The first load found it to be 1.8. First effort was 6.9. And our ratio found it to be 0.71. Our next load was 98.5. And our effort was 133.7. The ratio we found it to be 0.74. Then the last one, our load was 7.7, our effort was 67.7. So the ratio found it to be 0.70. So our graph of load against effort, and it originated, it was from the origin, a straight line with a gradient of 0.7.
Thank you very much. That is group
one.
Group one. Now, in the interest of time, I want all the secretaries come and just give us your result. All of you come. So may I have group 2 secretary coming, group 4 secretary coming, and group 7 secretary coming at the same time. Just write what you have for us. Come, please, in the interest of time.
Light.
Group 3 and 6. Now, from the various groups, we can see the group 1 are having their results here, group 2 are having theirs, the table, group 3, group 5, up to group 7. Now, what are we seeing from this result? I believe you are going through and you have seen from your result. Let us start with the table. What are we seeing from the table? What results are we getting from the table? Especially the ratio of load and effort. What are we getting? What are we seeing? That is common to all these tables. If I can see, group 1 is having 0.71, 0.73, 0.70. I pick randomly again, pick randomly group 6, 1.0, 1.2, 1.1, and 1.1. Again, I can see group 7 having 1.0, 0.9, 0.9, and 0.9. Group 5 again is having 1.2, 1.3, 1.1, and again 1.1. What are we coming up with the table values? Any contribution? Yeah? It gives us mechanical advantage. Any other? What are we saying? They are giving us a constant. What are we saying? We are getting the mechanical advantage to be constant and similar to the gradient. It's the same thing you wanted to say.
Yeah.
Okay. So what we are seeing from here, if we can take this to the one decimal place, you realize that here we are having 0.7, 0.7, 0.7, again 0.9, 0.9, 1.9 and 1.5, almost close, 0.7, 0.7, 0.7, again 0.8, 0.8, 0.9, and 0.8. So all these things are suggesting that the ratio of load to an effort is giving us a constant value. Is that true?
Yes.
Thank you. Again, if we can see from the graph, number one, what type of graphs are we obtaining in all these our groups? Yeah?
State graphs are generated from the
origin. State graph originating from?
The origin.
But I'm seeing one not originating from the origin. What could have been the problem? What do you think could have been the problem with this group? Yes?
They must have not been accurate enough.
They might have not been accurate enough. Any other opinion? In which areas would they have had a problem in? Yes? Okay, another one?
In determining the masses.
Yes.
Various loads.
Yeah. There might have been an error in that. Mm-hmm. And lastly, yes. Oh, you are a member of group 6?
Yeah, so,
yes.
So, with this one like this,
yeah.
You see that the load cannot be zero. So, ours did not start.
Thank you very much. Which is a good reason. The load is not supposed to be zero. But now, when we are looking at, when we are plotting the graph, finally we are being asked the significance of that graph. Simple.
Yes.
And you're also supposed to get the gradient of that graph. So when we are plotting this graph, it is the values that would have given us the line. Okay? And I believe you might have, as the one of us have said, you might have ignored the mass of the pan. So pan was also part of them. So it is true that they might have had a problem in their measurement. And the first problem would have been the measurement of the masses.
Yes.
That is where we are getting. And there could have also been in the measurement of the angle of inclination, okay? What other thing could have affected these results going by the inclined plane? Is there anything that you think might have affected the result? Yes, your hand is first.
So, like in our group, there was some point in which there was, we were experiencing
Lord at the surface of the climb where the experience of this process more faster.
We have also that one, eh? Any other problem you might have experienced apart from the part of the friction? Okay, so what are we saying? We are now saying that all these graphs are suggesting that the gradient is a constant. This graph is also a confirmation of what we have gotten from the ratios. So what are you saying? We have been asked the significance of this constant and the significance of the ratio or the gradient that we are getting. This is what is proving to us that we can be able to determine mechanical advantage of an inclined plane. So for that reason, the ratio, which is a constant, this ratio constant is what is known as mechanical advantage. And this gradient of this graph, given that it is a straight line graph, this graph is also telling us that the gradient is a constant, and that constant is what is equated to mechanical advantage. Thank you very much. Could we have any question from anything that is coming that was not clear to you? Any question? Yes, there's a question there.
So, is it okay to make the assumption that members of groups is made that alone should not be zero?
Yeah, it is. Remember when we are getting a ratio of load versus effort, it is not true that we are not supposed to assume that load cannot be zero. When you are starting your experiment, have you loaded anything?
No.
Have you measured anything?
No.
Yes, that is why at the origin, before you start your experiment, you don't have a load. You don't have
an effort.
Senior?
Yes.
So it is not true that group 6 members would have reasoned out that the load cannot be zero. It is zero before starting experiment. Silio?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Any other question? Yeah, there's a question here.
When we measure the load, do we put the mass of sand? Do we add the mass of the sand plus the pan? Or we just subtract?
Sir, is the pan also a force? Does it experience gravitational pull?
Yes.
So if the pan experiences gravitational pull, then the weight of the sand is also pulling the load. Remember, we have just used the sand to give us the effort whereby the load is able to be lifted up. Is that true?
Yes.
So the pan is matter, and it is also having its own weight. And that is why in the worksheet, you are told to measure the load and the effort, that is pan plus sand. Senior?
Yes.
Yeah, you are supposed to measure the masses of pan plus sand using a weighing balance, then you record it. So it is true that the pan was also acting as an effort. Yes, there's a question there.
Yes, sir. From the procedures, you are told that the angle of inclination to be around 40. Can it be less or more than 40?
Yeah, it can be less or more than 40. Remember, the angle of inclination is also a factor that is going to affect the mechanical advantage or the velocity ratio. Sound?
Yes.
Yeah, you are going to have that ratio. Remember, when the load is inclined like that, then we are having this angle here as theta, and this one being the length that is being moved by the load. See?
Yes.
So this becomes the load distance. And this one becomes
the effort distance.
H being effort distance. So for that reason, this angle, when we get the ratio of the height of a load, is always given as the sine of that angle theta, okay?
Yes.
So Since these lengths are dealing, well, these ratios are dealing with the lengths, these ones are going to see the effect in the velocity ratios. Therefore, this angle plays a very important role in the determination of both mechanical advantage as well as velocity ratio. It's only that here we were only interested in determination of the mechanical
advantage.
Next time we are supposed now to look at, can this length also affect mechanical advantage? Because we are going now to have the length place, we are going to place our loads at various lengths, and we see how does this length, can it also have an effect on mechanical advantage? Thank you very much. So if there is no other, is there any question? This is what we are saying, that the ratio of load to effort give us mechanical advantage. And this mechanical advantage can also be obtained from the gradient of the that's all. Yes. So we have come to a conclusion that mechanical advantage can also be obtained experimentally. Is that all right?
Yes.
Thank you very much. We have come to a conclusion of our lesson. May God bless you.